I think about Scooter every day. What made him special, why he inspires me in my life. 11 years ago, he was standing on this blue line. He would have loved to play in this game. He made the moment. The moment didn't make him. I'd ask all of us, players, fans, coaches, parents, to walk with Scott every day, to give every day the same heart, muscle, and joy that these players have tonight. What a gift that would be to him and to ourselves. Thank you.
Thank you so much for planning this event, and for Karen and Evelyn, what an amazing job. You know, it is hard to believe that 5 years has passed since Scott was killed. Imagine this, it's 14 years since our country was cowardly attacked on 9/11. 3,000 civilians were killed. The players on the ice here tonight were 3 and 4 years old. Scott was a sophomore at LS. The entire country came to a stop as we watched our country knocked to one knee, only to see the swell of patriotism raise her back up again. Critics say that watching videos of the attacks on our country could be disturbing to children. I say they should be played in every school across our nation as many times as possible, lest we ever forget what happened on that awful day. We continue to hear from Scott's men from time to time. A recent Facebook entry from one of his men said this: Lieutenant Milley was the only guy wearing bars on his shoulders that showed respect to me. Those are huge, very big words from an enlisted soldier. Another was this: he proceeded to tell a story that is now burnt into my memory. He said they were training on the firing range with machine guns. It was pouring rain, and they were lying down in the red Georgia mud. Scott was overseeing his platoon. When someone had a jam or difficulty using the weapon, Scott would lie down next to them in the mud and show them what they needed to know. Their lives depended on it. Hours later, Scott and his men were soaked and covered with red mud, as were the other two platoons of men training with them. But here's the part that makes it uniquely Scott. As all three platoons finished up, they got in formation to head back to the barracks. That's when Scott's men noticed the other platoon's officers, two lieutenants and a captain, dry and clean, sipping hot coffee as they watched their men train from the giant roof shelter at the rear of the firing line. That's just the leader Scott was. Military training and war itself does not build character. It reveals it. Scott's men saw that character and trusted him with their very lives. Many people ask us how we're doing 5 years later, and I have to tell you, the shock of hearing the words we regret to inform you, your son has been killed, has diminished a bit. But now, the sense of loss is greater. The weight of what will never be really sinks in. There's a legacy, though, and Scott's legacy will continue on through the work of his foundation. Just by your attendance here tonight, you're part of that work. Scott's foundation will bless people now and will continue for years to come. Just this week, we packed a bunch of Christmas stockings to go to soldiers recovering from brutal wounds at Walter Reed Hospital. We're sending off children bedtime storybooks to Walter Reed, where the dads can read the books aloud, and the book records their voice. Then the soldier dad sends the book home, and his children hear their dad's voice reading them their bedtime stories. What a great thing. I know Scott would love that. And all these things I mentioned, they're good things, but they come at a brutal cost. And that was Scott's tragic death. At every family gathering, there's an empty chair. A bitter reminder of the cost of freedom. It is my hope tonight that Concord Carlisle and Lincoln Sudbury continue to produce young men and women of character to lead our country in the years of uncertainty which lie ahead. God bless you all. Rangers, lead the way.